Hello and welcome to KWHE TV 14 Sports. Today we're here at beautiful Schofield Bowling Center for the Hammer Open. Hi, my name is Scott Mitumore, and here with me today is Carolyn Kawano.
Hi, Scott. We had a great turnout. We had 97 bowlers, and we have a special guest also with us as well.
Yeah.
And we had some good scorings, challenging scores on our 2009 USBC tournament oil pattern.
Yes, it was challenging, and there we have the overhead view of what the pattern looked like. We bowled on something similar to last week, but a little bit more volume of oil this week in the middle of the lane. Hopefully, the scores will be better. Last week was really tough, but it was challenging, and you know the lanes, as you can see, are starting to break down, hopefully the shot opens up, and we get some really good scores.
Yeah,
but it should be real challenging, and
we had our high score today of 269 by Virgil Dela Cruz.
That's right.
And 703 bowled by Daryl Okamoto. But unfortunately, he didn't make TV.
Yeah, what happened to them?
I don't know.
It's rough.
That's
when you get into match play, you know, anything can happen with our format. But we have some repeat bowlers from last week, and there's a reason why. They understand what to do. In our number one seed today, we have Jared Mizo.
Well, Jared's keys today is the soft release and relaxed swing. You know, he's three titles, averaged 220. He won his modified doubles with his father last week.
Last week. So he was top seed last week. Won one match to win the title, number three. He could do it again today.
He's going to have a tough one.
He's going to be challenged today because seated second today, we have Tony Reyes.
And that's our special guest of the day, Mr. Tony Reyes. His keys is to stay patient, good rhythm. He averaged 214 today. He's a PBA member all the way from San Jose.
That's right. And, you know, we all know Tony as bowling 300 on national TV. He's red hot and he barely made it through qualifying, but he turned it on in match play like all PBA members. He's always a threat anywhere in the lineup today. Seated third, we have Raymond Allen.
Raymond's keys today is to keep up his ball speed, have fun. He averaged 212 today. He's our one and only youth bowler on TV today. First time on TV, and you know, I heard he bowled a 298 yesterday at Subbase.
Well, he's red hot, and you know, he knocked off another youth player. We had total three that made the cut today.
Wow, that's a lot.
And really good showing on a real tough pattern today. Seated fourth, we have Chris Basilio.
Oh, Chris back again on TV. His keys today is to keep focused, trust the ball, you know, two times on TV, no titles yet, average 212. And he was on TV for modified doubles last week,
He was on last week. He likes this house. He bowls well here.
Let's see
if he can win his first title today. Seated fifth, we have Roy Yamanuha.
Okay, Roy's keys today is lots of luck. Pick up his spares. He averaged 205 today, Hall of Famer, 18 titles, and he's got a way to work up.
Yeah, he's at our fifth position, first TV match, you know. But Roy was ill for a while. He's back bowling, but watch out for him. Remember the last time we had a touring professional on our show, it was Robert Smith, and Roy knocked him out.
And he wants to knock this one out.
Let's see if Roy can make it up against Tony and see if he can beat Tony.
That'd be interesting.
He might be the Dragon Slayer out there. Should be interesting today. It should be great matches. We'll be right back after these messages with our first TV match. Okay, here we are at Schofield Bowling Center with Tony Reyes. This is the Hammer Open. Welcome, Tony.
Aloha.
All right.
Yeah, nice to be here.
This is our first TV match, and let's get started.
All right, right on.
All right. First TV match, we're going to have Chris Basilio against Roy Yamanuha. Welcome, everyone. Once again, we are here at Schofield. This is the Hammer Open. Scott Mitumore here with Tony Reyes and Carolyn Kawano.
Hello there. Hey, today, Roy had games of 226, 189, and 189 for 604. He went on to defeat Scott Ibarra, 247 to 200, and then he went on to defeat Daniel Thiessen, 178 to 121.
It looked like Roy's throwing that brand new hammer jigsaw, right?
Brand new jigsaw ball just came out last week, actually.
How did he get it so quick?
Probably has a pretty good driller.
Yeah.
Got some connections.
We're out here in Hawaii. We got the ball in 1 week, right after it was released.
Well, we also had the demo balls, too. So,
that's right.
Yeah.
Here's Chris Basilio. Second time, 2 weeks in a row on TV. And that's a rude awakening for him. It's not nice.
Back-to-back shows. Wow, nice.
Back-to-back shows, yeah.
Yeah.
Chris leaves a 4-6-7 split.
Okay, well, Christian had games of 226, 217, and 214 for a 657 series. He then went on to defeat Blaine, 183 to 179, and then went to defeat Virgil De La Cruz, 221 to 206.
Virgil had the high score for the tournament.
269.
269, knocked him out.
They were not very easy today. Not at all. And Carolyn, when you announce my scores, please you can skip over my first. Thank you. I appreciate it. They're pretty tough, but definitely it was challenging, and it's nice to have a turn like that every now and then, you know. Sure.
We're gonna see you later on today, semifinal match, and Chris looks lined up on lane 41 there. Now we're back to Roy Yamanuha. Long time no see for Roy.
I know. Welcome back, and you know, great recovery back. He was ill. Good to have him back bowling. He is retired. He currently averaging 199. He'd like to say special thanks to Daniel and Darren at Strike'em Pro Shop. Without them, he wouldn't be on TV today. And first physical rehab for his physical game.
Oh, physical rehab? Is that where I went? No.
That's
a mean place. Fixed him up pretty good. I mean, he's back here on TV.
He's a shot maker.
He is. Well, Roy's won.
You know?
He's won our Senior Bowl of the Year, like, I don't know how many times already. I mean, I don't know if you heard our opening, but he knocked off Robert.
Yeah, that's what you told
at
me.
At K-Bay, yeah.
Yeah. He's a giant killer. So,
oh, he sure
know.
Is. Yeah. Yeah.
Doesn't seem like a senior bowler.
No. I've competed with Roy in the regionals at Lihue and also over here.
Some
in
people
Island,
don't realize he won one of the senior high rollers, too, in Vegas.
Oh, wow.
That's
I didn't know that.
Right. That's
yeah,
right.
Kind of sneaky. He doesn't tell anyone that.
I remember that one.
Well, you could definitely see the difference on how this pattern is playing. It's the USBC, United States Bowling Congress pattern for the big championships, and you see the difference where Chris is playing compared to where Roy is, and you got to make some shots.
Yeah,
be comfortable. And
what was
there.
Pretty good is you could play most any part of the lane.
Close to it.
And yeah. Like you can see Roy's playing out, Chris playing in, and wherever you choose, you need to make shots.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's why I'm here in the penalty box again.
Believe me, I could easily have been right here with you. And I'm lucky enough to be bowling here. But
well, you did a great
easily.
Comeback.
But yeah, it'll be tough, though. You got a great field out there with these five gentlemen. And it's been a pleasure, definitely, so far. So.
Well, thank you for coming. And let's thank Mike Quitter for sending you out here, representing Hammer. In fact, all the different lines that Ebonite represents, Hammer, Columbia, Track, and of course Ebonite.
Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you. Well, Christian is separated and he has two children. He's a truck driver and currently averaging 214. And we just like to say thanks to USBC.
Oh, he likes, yeah, he likes his
See,
pattern.
It's the pattern.
This is a tough pattern.
There you go.
2 weeks on TV.
Well, he knows something we don't know.
Oh, yeah, I think he knows. You know.
So does Tony.
Gets the inside scoop of the patterns, I'm sure.
But, you know, Chris is one of our senior players, and he talks it up pretty good for a senior.
Oh, I talked to him earlier before we started, absolutely. that's what you got to be out here. Sometimes, you got to, what I call is fake it till you make it. You got to believe it in yourself before you do it. And, you know, I mean, that's part of the confidence, inner confidence that that great bowlers have. Chris has that. Roy has that.
Right, right.
You know, you see that from some of them. You know, definitely.
I lost that.
So did I. I think I better start doing
I think
too.
I'm just faking too much.
Too much? Too many?
Roy switches to...